Chenmei Baxi. Él es TED Speaker, es campeón IBM y el desarrollador más joven de IBM Watson. Él solo tiene 14 años y quiero que le demos un fuerte aplauso, una cálida bienvenida a Chenmei Baxi.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Welcome. Hello, everyone. My name's Chenmei Baxi, and my passion is to explore technology. More specifically, I love developing, working with, and implementing algorithms that enable our machines to think and reason for themselves, even though we can all agree that a computer's only capability is with mathematical information. In essence, I love to take a bunch of the different algorithms that take our human ability of being able to learn and quantify that into mathematics and apply them in fields where I believe they can make the most impact. But before I get into that machine learning technology, what I'm doing with it, and how it can even help us as developers, I'd like to begin by saying a huge thank you to the entire team here at Keep Coding Connect 2018 for putting together this wonderful event here in Madrid, and also for inviting me to Madrid. In fact, this is my very first time in Spain, and I'm already loving it here. In fact, the reason that I'm here in Spain today is because I'm really passionate about machine learning and deep learning technology. In fact, as we speak, this machine learning technology is impacting hundreds of fields and hundreds of thousands of lives across the globe. In fact, we've all used AI today without even realizing it, from the simplest to even the most complex tasks. And the reason this machine learning technology is so powerful is because it enables computers to do things that even we as humans in some cases may find difficult. Like, for example, there are some skills that we humans are born with that sometimes we barely even realize that we have. Like, for example, we're all great at understanding natural language information. We're all great at understanding visual information. You understand that the eye on screen right now isn't actually like 2 meters across. You understand the perspective and the scale of that eye on screen. And we're also great at understanding auditory data. You can hear me right now because you have that ability. In fact, one more of the abilities that we have out of the many, many unique abilities that humans have, and one that you may not realize at first, is actually very uniquely human, something that computers have never and will never be able to do. And that is, well, coding. We're great at programming, we're great at developing applications, we're great at developing systems. And it might not seem like it at first. It might seem like developing is such an analytical, such a mathematically intensive task. But when you take a look at it, it's actually something that requires a lot of imagination, something that requires a lot of creativity. Because, well, unless we have the imagination to think of new kinds of architectures and flows and different kinds of applications and different kinds of algorithms, it's simply impossible for us to code in new applications and create new systems. But on the other hand, as we all know, computers are only good at crunching numbers. They're only good at running mathematical operations, albeit they can do so exponentially faster than any other human ever could or ever will be able to, but still, that's the only thing they can do. With machine learning, though, you can actually get kind of the best of both worlds. So you can understand unstructured data using the power of mathematics. This is the computer's greatest ability. And then, because machine learning is so flexible, you can apply it to almost any task. It's really just a set of mathematics that's used to build a numeric model, which can then transform new data that it's never seen before into predictions. So all we need to do is feed in data and the kinds of architectures and algorithms and support the machine learning algorithm on its way to learn. So we don't need to hard code every single individual conditional ourselves. And now computers can work with new data and make predictions on them. And then we can solve problems that we never could have solved before using this machine learning technology. Imagine the application in fields that actually have a lot of data. Like, for example, healthcare, which is the one field that I'm most passionate about. In fact, fact, I've created and I'm currently working on applications that enable us to detect depression even before it evolves into anything serious by using the power of machine learning so we can actually stop suicide even at the depression level. I'm also working on applications that enable us to provide a kind of artificial communication ability to those who can't communicate naturally. And the way I do this is by understanding their electroencephalogram brainwaves through custom deep learning algorithms that I develop. I'm also working on different algorithms that enable us to diagnose hearing disorders in much faster ways to help out audiologists. And the best part is that this specific kind of neural network is also going to provide justification for why it makes the decisions it makes, so audiologists don't need to double or triple check the AI's work. And I'm also working on a project with a startup in India that enables us to predict adverse events that people may experience to drugs even before they take the drug, and even if that specific person and that specific clinic or that specific chemical structure of a drug has never been tested in a clinical trial ever before. That's why machine learning is so powerful, and that's why I'm so passionate about applying machine learning technology. But before I delve deeper into another one of my projects and how I'm implementing AI in another field, there is one quick demo of an AI application that I'd love to show you all as developers. This application is called Bayou. You may have heard of it. It's essentially an AI assistant for your code. Now, of course, we've all used IDEs, we've all used coding autocomplete, but we know it's not really very intelligent. It's really just a string search or a string matching algorithm. That's all it is. However, with Bayou, you can take coding autocomplete to the next level by having neural networks using a custom machine learning algorithm called neural sketch learning actually guess what you are trying to code and code it in for you based off of nothing but a little description of what you're trying to get done. Now again, instead of me standing here and telling you more about Bayou and how it works, I'd love to show you a demo of the system in action. Let's take a look. All right, so now what I'm gonna do over here is I'm going to switch over to a code window with the Atom IDE. You should be able to see this any moment. Now, there we go. Now, as you can see, of course, if you're familiar with Java, this is really, really, really simple code. In essence, all this is we're creating a class called InputOutputDemo. We have a main function that creates a new instance of the class. And here, I just create a new file, and this refers to actually the same directory that this code is in with the helloworld.txt, which is a file that does not exist yet. And then all I do is I call a write function that's declared at the bottom over there. And what I do is I write hello world. This is a program developed in part by Neural Sketch Learning over to that file. Then I read the file and print the contents of that file out. Now, as you can tell, the read and write functions currently don't do anything. And so what I need to do is fill out this code. But I'm not going to stand here and code in a bunch of lines in front of you right now. Rather, what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this code over to this application called Bayou. It's completely open source, and you can download it if you wish and run it locally. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this into a little bit of kind of replication of this class that I've created here. And now, all I need to do is go ahead and create a hole. This is what tells Bayou that this is where you need to fill in code. And all I'm going to tell it is call add call readline. That's all I'm telling it. I'm not telling it which file to read a line from. I'm not telling it which types to use. I'm not telling it that you have to append those lines to the array list. But right as I click the magnifying glass, this is going to use a neural sketch learning algorithm. It's going to guess the different parameters that needs to go into, and just like that, any second now, you should see that it generates a bunch of code for us. And this is all generated by neural network. As you can see, I can then take this code, copy it, and back into Atom, and just like so, or in the read function, and there we go. I just format the code a little better. And then all I can do is actually deal with the exceptions. And so I can do something like file not found, there we go, or an IO exception. And now I've got a reading function. Then I can do the exact same thing for the write function. I'm going to take this back over to the class. And then again, I'm going to create a hole. And inside this hole, I'm going to say call write. No other information. And it's going to guess that the file is what you need to write to, and the content is what you need to write. And so again, any second now, you should see that indeed it has created a new file writer, and as you can see, it automatically guessed that the file is what needs to be written to, and the content is what it needs to write. That's why machine learning technology is so powerful. I then go ahead and take this, copy it into my write function, I go ahead and deal with the exception, and there we go, I've now created a fully fledged Java application, just like that. I can then head over to my terminal window over here, and all I need to do is run Java C to compile, just like that, and it compiled successfully, and now in theory, I should be able to do so, and as you can see, it prints out, hello world, this is a program developed in part by Neural Sketch Learning, and the reason it did that was because, as you can see, it created a new file with the contents I gave it, and then read those all out through machine learning. That's why machine learning is so powerful. I hope you enjoyed that demo. And it's not just powerful in actually developing applications anymore, in developing intelligent applications. It even helps you out as you're developing those applications to make your application development process that much more efficient. Again, I hope you enjoyed that demo of how it can help us out as developers. In fact, this BYU technology is important because it enables us as developers to focus on what we need to focus on the most, and that is solving problems, developing applications that enable us to solve major problems using technology, and now using next-generation technology like machine learning. In fact, there's an application in another field that I'm really passionate about, and the field is disaster preparedness. And there's an application that I developed that I'd love to share with you today, and it's called Tandro, which stands for Tanmay's Drone. The entire point of this application is essentially to create a virtual co-pilot. I guess you could say an artificial intelligence-based co-pilot for you to actually pilot different kinds of vehicles, more specifically in this case drones, more efficiently through the power of natural language. So instead of you having to sit there and actually control buttons manually, you can give descriptions of what you want done to a chatbot, and it'll automatically try and understand the intent behind what you're saying, using the semantics of your language, not just the syntactics of it. And, well, why would this be useful? When I could control it much more precisely using buttons or an application, why would I want natural language? Well, think about this. Say you're piloting a drone to deliver medical supplies in a place that's actually currently under a natural disaster. Let's just say you're delivering this inside of a, or near, a forest fire. Now, of course, a forest fire is a very unpredictable scenario. You could have branches falling down on a drone that you would never see because you as a human don't have nearly enough good of a reaction time to actually deal with that. Therefore, the drone will be disabled and cannot do what it's meant to do. But with the power of machine learning technology, though, you have microsecond level reaction time embedded onto the drone that can automatically steer clear of obstacles and get done what you want it to get done. This is how it works. And the entire point of the architecture that's being drawn out here is to enable users to control the drone from absolutely anywhere. Because I'm using the Twilio communications platform, meaning that I can make use of SMS data, meaning that no matter where you are, no matter which device you're using, as long as you have access to SMS and you can text your instructions over to Twilio, you can both get information about the drone through an IoT platform powered by Watson or powered by the IBM Cloud, and you can then go ahead and send information to the drone in completely natural language as if there's an actual human co-pilot there controlling the drone with you. And again, this is done through Watson Assistant and using the IBM IoT platform. And the entire reason that I developed this application is because it ties in a lot with an initiative that I'm personally very passionate about. The initiative is called the Call for Code. The entire point of this initiative is to bring developers from across the globe together so we can all use next-generation technology like machine learning, IoT, blockchain, and maybe even quantum computing if you're up for it, and actually take this next-generation technology and help out those who are being affected by natural disasters, more specifically, the 80,000 people that are affected directly or indirectly by natural disasters every single day. This initiative is founded by the Linux Foundation and IBM in partnership, and if you'd like to sign up, you can go to developer.ibm.com/callforcode. And that's why I developed this application, and that's, again, why I'm really passionate about using machine learning to actually help us as developers to solve more problems. However, before I go today, There is one misconception that I'd like to clear, a misconception about machine learning that a lot of people have, especially once you took a look at the Bayou demo and now Tandro. You might be thinking, well, AI is meant to replace us. Machine learning is meant to overtake us, become more intelligent than humans, and eventually get to artificial general intelligence. But this is simply not true. Rather, the entire point of AI is that it was created by us as humans to augment our intelligence, really amplify our capabilities, and allow us to do things that we never could have done before. And that's why I believe we shouldn't be afraid of AI. Rather, we should be embracing it because it's going to empower us. Like, for example, with the Bayou demo, computers don't have imagination. They don't have any artistic capabilities. They don't have creativity. They're just hard-coded mathematical structures. And due to that, they're not replacing us as developers. Rather, they're enabling us to do what we do best, solve problems using code, using programming, but they're allowing us to do it more efficiently. And that's why I'd like to say that really artificial intelligence doesn't even just look like AI anymore. It looks a lot more like IA, intelligence augmented, intelligence amplified, taking what we're so good at, our unique human ability of learning, our unique human ability of intelligence, combining that with a computer's mathematical capability to get the best of both worlds and understand unstructured data at scale. Thank you very much, everyone, for joining in today. Thank you.
Un aplauso.
Thank you.